Good evening, people, ladies and gentlemen. We have a match of Dota 2 for the 4PL Cup number 10. It is going to be Quantic versus Team Austria. And we're going to see one game between these two teams. This is a game in round 4. And they are fighting for a spot in, I think, I don't think there's a name for it, like the 8th finals or something like that. Huh. There's at least 7 rounds in total, so I might be wrong. Finals, semifinals, yeah, I don't know. Never mind, it is a game in round 4, Quantic versus Team Austria. Quantic on the Radiant side, Team Austria on the Dire side. And, I am not sure what these two teams are doing. Normally I would say something about 4PL, and I would say something about... Well, oh no, sorry, wait, I know what they're doing. Wow, sorry, brain fart. So there was a, the drafting phase is already done. In case you're wondering. So we should have been in an old pick phase. But since the draft is already done, let's see if something is being said in the chat. This is actually the lineup. Pick fast. So we're not gonna have a remake for an old pick phase, we're just gonna do this. I was wondering, what are these bands? Dark Sia. The Shrek. Look at these picks. How did they get through to the pool? Naga, Siren, Rubik, Darkseid, maybe these bans were actually legit. I don't think so, but it's still cool. Dire team ban. Is it Kurokai? Is it Kuroki? Kuroki? It might be. Oh, that was a wisp sound. I was wondering what that was. Beastmaster picked Venomancer. Up. We'll go over the draft in a moment, though. But you know, I'm just getting over my initial shock of seeing all these heroes in the pool. They remade after the drafting phase, and Juggernaut. Radiant team pick. Windrunner at your service. Really? Wow. Just wow. We'll see how this is gonna go. It is Quantic versus Team Austria, and I do realize that I have to put on the team names because I didn't activate their team profiles. So it's going to be Quantic on the Radiant side, Quantic Gaming, with the Dire side being Team Austria. Yeah, you can type, it's cool. So, that is going to be it. That is going to be lineup. We're waiting for people to pick up the last heroes, and then we can go again. And yeah, I don't know. I mean, the Rubik is there to counter the Enigma. Black Hole. If he manages to steal Black Hole, there will be a vacuum Black Hole for the Dire team. Remaining. And if you have a vacuum Black Hole, there will be a Turley guy, Blade Fury, and through that, Juggernaut. But of course, if that's going on, there could always be a sign for the Naga Siren. But then Naga Siren's song can be stolen as well. We have a disconnect, so we might have we'll probably have a little pause. As we have Beastmaster already moving down to the bottom lane, probably gonna kill off some trees here. I really don't know what to do with this. There we go. There we go. Making people happy all over the planet. Let's see who's playing. Well, you can't really see who's playing what because not everything is being put on, picked up yet. Miracle Chipmunk is ready though. And in case you're wondering, it is indeed Quantic Gaming. And they do have 3 of their members, but they have 2 stand-ins. So we have Cork, who is playing the Naga Siren. We have Brax on the Enigma. Miracle Chipmunk is actually a friend of Korok's, who is going to be playing. I will call him Chipmunk, though, because that's more fun than Miracle Chipmunk. It's just Chipmunk. And it will be Painted Gold, and then Painted Gold and Warrior will still be having to pick up one of the heroes that is left in this pool. Yeah, I was gonna say. It was just a remake after the picks, that's why I went so fast. We have got the Invoker being played by Kill on Team Austria on the Dire side. Charader, who is the standard in this game, is gonna be playing the Rubik. We're gonna have Blister playing the Juggernaut. We're gonna have the Beastmaster being played by Tenzer. And that will leave Nutty still playing one of the heroes that is not yet picked up, and I do think it was a Darkseer. Bam! Just like that. Darkseer will be the last pickup for Nutty on the... Ooh. Did he just change his name? Okay, he changed his name. XKM is going to be the name, and it's a stand-in for Team Austria. He will play the Darkseer, though. for the Radiant team, what we're still missing, which heroes are we still missing? I guess I didn't pay as much attention to that one. I guess I didn't. Shame for me. They don't have heads. I said vacuum black hole for the team fight. They can't do that because they can steal the black hole from the Rubik. I see that someone from the chat just said that. But if Rubik steals a black hole, that's going to be having the Wombo Coma regardless. And of course, black hole is one of those spells that is a channeled spell. So if Rubik is not in the black hole and he is around, he will guaranteed be able to steal that black hole. There we go. It's Venomancer that's being picked up there. It's going to be played by Painted Gold. The last hero, not yet picked up, but will be played while we're... And we have a pause coming off from Painted Gold, knowing that, you know, one of the players has his Dota 2 crashing, which will probably be Warrior. On his last hero for Warrior. Deal with it. Wow, that's not very friendly. Oh, I like this courier. I do like this courier. Let's see what courier they have. They don't have one yet. No courier. All these heroes not picking up anything yet, apart from the Enigma, who has actually bought something already. Let's put something in there. There we go. That was needed. But yeah, that's the team fight that is possible on the Dire side. And of course, Juggernaut over the top. Maybe, wait, well, not a tornado, because then you, yeah, like, stop them from taking damage from the rest, but Meteor, Deafening Blast. It's all those kind of things that they can just do. They can just get. And if they get the black hole, of course, they have to get that first. But then again, like I said, if there's gonna be that combo moment, there will be the Mega Siren that might be able to throw down a song before anything else happens. In which case, everybody will be able to back off, and you can boo all you want. But that is actually a good spell to have right now on the Radiant side. At the same time, the song will make sure that I think Rubik is gonna be in that black hole every single time if he's around, because as soon as Korok sees that there is a good potential for a black hole for Brax, he will song, making sure that everybody is sitting still, because they're sleeping, and he'll be able to just throw down a black hole and just be able to let it cast. And, you know, get that teamfight going. Of course, if you think about what they have going through that, they have got the Venomancer ulti, which is nice, and they've got a power shot. And like I said, since it's an old pick draft, I kind of forgot what this last pick was for Quantic. And I have still not seen that in the chat either, unfortunately. I should know it, though. Should know it. And there you have Infinity reconnecting, but that is just an observer. And we'll wait until Warrior is back. Picking a hero. Taking a long time. Wombo combo combo wombo, really, I say it wrong all the time. But yeah. Then again, if you're it's gonna come down to lane, even though I think that the Dire side has got a pretty strong laning phase. Invoker is pretty strong on the lane. Darkseer, I mean, he's not that strong on the lane in itself, as in he's not gonna get kills. But he will be able to stop, he will be able to push the lane back, making sure that his tower is not going to go down. And in theory, he shouldn't die. I mean, in the previous game, we saw him going down quite a lot. But with his Surge, he should be staying alive. At least he keeps the lane stable. Rubik is a pretty strong laning partner. With his Telekinesis and his Fate build, he's able to just turn the odds around if there's going to be initiation. And of course, Juggernaut, Blaze Fury. Quite painful Invoker. Yeah, they have a pretty strong laning phase indeed. For Quantic, that is a bit more tricky. I mean, they have got Naga Siren, who can be argued to have an okay laning phase with her ensnare and stuff, if the Venomancer is going to be on her lane as well. But if she's going to be on the hard lane, well, no, I don't know. She's going to have an average laning phase. Let's put it that way. And it's the Lashrak that was the last one that gets picked up there. So it was the Lashrak, and everybody moving towards the top lane. I do think it's going to be the Shrek maybe on the mid lane, didn't go for Vorzpin. Gold gonna be supporting with Enigma perhaps in the jungle, and bottom lane for, or the side solo lane for Chipmunk on his Windrunner. And it was it was the Lushrak. So actually Lushrak, another good spell to steal for the Rubick. Wow, Rubick has a lot of good spells to steal here. Shackle, Power Shots, Black Holes, Song if he's lucky. Basically there's not a lot of bad spells to steal right here. Well, maybe the Lightning, if it's not skilled all that high, is gonna be a bad one to steal. Venomous Wards are useful to steal, Gale is useful to steal. Venomous Ulti is useful to steal, whoa, and Snare, Darkseer in some trouble here. There's a Gale is gonna hit as well. Juggernaut here though, he's got Blade Fury, nice Shackle, but they can't do anything here. Telekinesis up, look at that damage being done, Lushrak on the way out, and it's Enigma that picks up the first blood. With Darkseer going down still and Snare up on the jungle, they might get another kill here, and they do. Enigma double kill! Lushrak still alive, wanted to go for a stun. Is he gonna get it on the Rubick? He is gonna get it on the Rubick. Will there be another Gale? Yes, there will be, if he is fast enough. Is he fast enough? Shackle is not latching, but is at least keeping him at bay for now. Gale still hits, and Snare still hits as well. Will there be enough damage? Another right click needed. Maybe another one. No, there is the Cell, but he will be staying alive. 2-0 in favor of Quantic. Before the game even starts. But look at Quantic, they're all so low on HP, and they have to back off, and they have to use their trees, use their tangos, use their salves. I'm not sure if that is a good thing. Well, they got two kills, like, yeah, I can call that a good thing. Enigma is the one that picks up the kills there, is the one that gets the advantage, and looks to be going in solo mid lane for him. Maybe he's rotating to the jungle in later on, but he already has a Sol Ring by those kills. Getting the first blood, getting the double kill, TP out there from Windrunner, who will be going on the hard lane. Easy lane, hard lane going for Naga Siren as well as Lushrak, and there's not going to be a jungle hero for now with Venomancer and a tri lane together with the, oh nice, Venomancer in a tri lane and stealing some right clicks from the Darkseer, or at least only one Darkseer who is going to be jungling, or at least looks to be jungling. Juggernaut on the top lane will be up versus the tri lane with the Rubick being there. As support Gale hits on the Juggernaut, he will be able to play Fury Wave as making the stun not hit, but he is very low on mana now, can only do it 2 times more with the Clarity Potion there, if you count that, take that into account. And he will have to use it if they really want to go aggressive, which, like I said, he is a good laning partner if you can go aggressive, but right now he is going to be shut down. It's this tri lane, there's nothing that he can really do against that. And Snare there, the Shrek following up with the stun on the Snare. Gale there, if he has mana, which he doesn't, and he also doesn't have any regens anymore. That's the downside of having that fight in the early game. I'm gonna put the last hits in the ice because you want to see those. But it's Brax, it's Enigma that is having the favor of this game so far, and he's getting a lot of islands here to secure his last hits, being able to get 11-7 so far with only 4 last hits for the Invoker. I'm gonna stick around a bit on this top lane because I do think that is where the most action is gonna happen. One in Snare, one stun from Lushrak. And if a Juggernaut would not have any mana, then it will be a kill, but right now he has mana, and they know that too. So they might try to bait out the Blade Fury before doing anything else. Illusion Rune up on the Rubick. It's gonna be, I'm not sure where it's gonna be used for. It's gonna find the Venomizer, that's for sure. Knowing that he is there, but he probably knows it's an illusion there. Yeah, now they definitely know it. We need to have bottom lane. Reason I'm not really watching here is because both Beastmaster and Windrunner should in theory be okay. Beastmaster also using his board to try to stack up this stack, most likely to get some solid experience later on in the game. And he will get that. By the way, one thing I didn't point out just yet is an upside for the Juggernaut being here outnumbered. He is getting experience, a lot more experience than the Naga Siren is. Or at least some more experience than the Naga Siren. Naga Siren is slightly behind on experience compared to that Juggernaut. Darkseer though, why are you so low? You're in the jungle, you shouldn't be dying. He doesn't have any regen anymore either, so I'm not sure what he's thinking he's gonna do here. What he's thinking he's gonna stay alive. He's being very close though. Oh, he kills up too, that's nice of him. But he's being forced back out. Oh, gets the last hit. Aim shells all around. Maybe he's gonna get him. We'll leave him to it though. Leave him to it, see if he's gonna die. We're gonna see a Darkseer being killed by a neutral, but I guess he's just gonna back to base. So 500 gold has got enough mana for the. Ooh, wait a second, and Snare. There's the Lushrak start, Edict, and that is gonna be a Rubick dying to the Lushrak. That is the combination I was talking about. And Snare, stun, edict there, and there was nothing that they could do against it. Juggernaut's just happy that he didn't die in his place. And Rubik already on his way back again. Darkseer on his way back as well. He's got, that's what I said, he has 500 gold, has got enough gold for boots, and he did pick up his boots. Indeed. Windrun in the meantime being 26 for 7, doing a very good job here harassing this Beastmaster, who's only 7 for 1. But then again, like I said, Beastmaster is not too unhappy about not getting that much farm. He will get his farm up with this Ancients, these Ancients. Juggernaut getting harassed, will there be an ensnare? He's full on mana again though. So if they do ensnare him, he will be able to just Blade Fury out of there. And don't want to force it, especially not since the Rubik is there. We'll be able to telekinesis and Fatebolt someone, which might be turning out badly. So they only want to go for it when they know they're going to be able to get it. Like, they could have gone for it now, but Lashrak not close by enough, so no ensnare needed. Juggernaut getting some last hit still. He's 8 for 0, I mean, he's not getting that much done. And I mean, wasn't expecting him to, after we knew that he was up for his trial lane. 23 for 10, though, on the Naga Siren. Looks like they might want to go aggressive on this. We're getting some harassment up on Korok on his Naga Siren. Darkseer fairly close by here as well. Clearing out the trees, clearing out the jungle. Enigma in the meantime, level 6, so we might see some black holes being used. Invoker still level 4. That is the power of Enigma, just denying those creeps. Combined, of course, with him getting those 2 kills at the start of the game. Getting that extra experience up. Invoker almost level 5 is going for Quas Exort. Wants to go for that extra damage, wants to go for those stun strikes if he can get it. Beastmaster in the meantime, taking a gale, taking a lot of damage, it will probably die. Windrunner picking up the kill. Solid kill. Nothing really to get all that excited about. Venomancer helping out there. Leaving his lane in the top lane. In the meantime, Joe Juggernaut, Edict, finish it off. Lashrak wants to go for more. Gets a Rubik double kill for Warrior. And will he get a triple kill? Darkseer in the midst of all of this uses his vacuum. And Snare there though. Sunstrike as well. But that is the Sunstrike that will kill off the Naga Siren. Triple kill for Lashrak though. He still got a kill on the Darkseer. Sunstrike at least. At least they get something in return. That was the first kill being done on the Dire side, and that goes to the Invoker. Getting some experience, extra experience on his middle lane. He is building towards his face boots, has it complete actually. Just need the donkey to be off duty for now, which he will have soon. Meantime, tier 3 tower, tier 2, tier 1 tower rather, getting pressured here. Beastmaster can't do that much about it. But like I said, I mean, really, Ancient stack getting bigger and bigger. Juggernaut actually rotates here, thinking he will get more from here. War on the Venomancer, who will drop here. Another kill here for Team Austria, as that was a successful roar. Beastmaster just turned level 6, or was level 6 and able to use it. Tower still goes down, but, you know, at least they get something in return, which is a kill on the support. Better than nothing. They got a kill already on the main carry for Quantic, which is a big thing. But he is not getting stopped. Core farming 29 for 13, he's got his power threats complete. And Lashrak level 6, he's got his mana boots complete also. I mean, he's the one that just got that triple kill. High level, Rubik's still level 3. I'm just going to put up that one, because that one will show a massive difference. I mean, those two kills in the start of the game, they gave everybody about a level, a bit less than a level. They gave everybody a bit less than a level experience on that top lane, but this is looking way more than a level. Look at that Enigma, level 8 versus the level 6 from the Invoker. It is just so much difference right now, as the gank is being set up here for Killa on this middle lane. And will there be a gale? Yeah, will be a gale, but it misses. So that is actually not a gale. They don't care though, they'll go for the tower instead. Fortification is still there if they want to use it, but they don't. Juggernaut in the meantime, killing off the Windrunner and using his ultimate to do that. Windrunner level 8 versus Juggernaut level 6, level 7 is not going to do anything for his Omni Slash. Not even, well, I guess the Windrunner wasn't there, only level 1 anyway. Tier 2 tower getting pressured, Iron Lung's helping out. If they want to fight this, they have to be ready to go for a black hole. Vacuum clearing out some of the creeps. The Shrek they're thinking about still going in and throwing down an Edict. But it's too risky. He doesn't want to get vacuumed in. I don't blame him. Windrunner back on the bottom lane. And it looks like Quantic backs out. Having done half the HP of the tower. Going, I mean, slowly but steadily, but they got this for free. Free gold. Juggernaut in the meantime. Level 8. And now finally getting some more last hits. I mean, his last hits are 22 for 2, which is by all means not impressive, but it's a lot more than he had on the top lane. In the meantime, top lane, Rubick. Lushrak once again, mega kill. Lushrak being 5 for 0. That is impressive. Of course, he's not done it alone. He's been getting a lot of help with the Riptide there and Snare probably as well. But still, pretty solid. And Rubick still level 4, up versus Lushrak level 6. Level 9 Enigma, level 7 Nyga Siren. Okay, we weren't really expecting anything else. Power Shot will not hit on Blister, even though he's very low here. But he is with the Beastmaster, and Beastmaster has a roar back up again. So as soon as Windrunner shows himself, herself, that might not end all too well, even though she might just think to get a quick kill on up on this guy. Tier 1 tower drops. No more tier 1 towers on the side of the Dire as this ensnare hits on the Rubick. Telekinesis there, Roar as well up on Korok though, but here comes Brax making sure that everybody backs off, making sure that his teammate is safe. Mana boost being used because the Shrek has those. He's got one cable already. He is a bit pretty firm support of the Shrek. I mean, he's on a tri lane, but he's doing good. Look at this golf minute, wow. The reason this is such a big difference though is of course also because of the towers. I mean, let's get real. Three towers down on the side of the Dire. Song being used. This is a good setup for a black hole. He might be able to get every single one of those. And he is. And there's going to be Lushrak stun going through. Hits on all three. Eating Nova. Lushrak picking up a kill. Enigma picking up a kill. Naga Siren picking up a kill. One for each. Three heroes going down, and they might just decide to continue pushing. They have got an edict in 9 seconds again. They'll just get rid of the creep wave here. New creep wave coming in for the Radiant side. And that might be the first tier 2 tower going down on the side of the Dire. There goes Edict. And that is a quick tower for them. As the fortification is still up if they want to use it, but it doesn't look like they do. So there it goes. Dire's Venomancer who came here just to check it out, just to see what the fuzz was about. Placing some wards. Wasn't there for the team fight itself, though. If you can call it a team fight, it was kind of a massacre, right? Pretty big massacre at that. Windrunner building towards a 4 staff. Vision was already up on the Enigma. Let's see if I missed any other items. 2600 gold from the Nyga Siren. We're probably going to see him going for the Radiance if he has the money to do that. Oh, Blister. Taking some damage from Edict. Are you sure you want to be standing there? I don't think you are sure. Roar goes up, and it's actually Enigma that drops there. As the Shrek is going to be trying to get away from that one. Sunstrike will not hit, but Nyga Siren will go down regardless. Invoker will go down still as Windrunner picks up that kill on the Rubick as well. Beastmaster on the way out, as well as a Darkseer getting chased down. Will there be something? No more mana left on the Venomancer, but there is an Urn Charge. Will it get him down though? It might. Yes, it will. It definitely will. The Venomancer triple kill. I don't believe it. Painted Gold support Venomancer triple kill. Urn Charge is doing its work, but this is the only guy left alive on Team Austria. Who throws down some axes, but his tower is already dead, and it's gonna be Roshan that's gonna be the reward of that team fight. And it started out so good also. Well, I say it started out good, but well, they killed off the Nyga Siren, but Nyga Siren bought back. But yeah. I don't think anybody else bought back. Well, actually, sorry. Enigma bought back as well. He died in that fight. So 2-4-4 in theory, but and they got 2 buybacks, so not all bad. But definitely not bad for Quantic for sure. Not that bad for Team Austria, but then again, you know, of course they rather would have more heroes left alive at the end of that fight. And Boots of Travel up on the Enigma. He just bought back, wanted to get back on that fight instantly, and just thought, you know what? He wants to go for that.
Dire's bottom tower is under attack.
I don't really know what to say anymore. That doesn't happen often. But it looks like Quantic is just looking so much ahead right now. Look at that gold graph, 15k. Experience graph not as impressive, but still in favor. And tier 3 tier 2 tower is the last tier 2 tower standing on the map. We'll drop here. And Lushrak picking up the gold once more. Poor staff. Shackle is not working though. And I might just want to continue, even though the black hole will 10 seconds cooldown, so they might want to use it. By the way, all towers are still up on the side of the Radiant, which will make sure that the gold per minute, look at that difference. Normally you get your support's gold by killing off towers and getting that early gold advantage, or at least, maybe not advantage, but getting that early gold. But right now, no early gold, and not just for the supports, but just for nobody. For nobody, Juggernaut not able to carry his team so far. Team Austria looking to be in a tough position right here. And they have not managed to steal the black hole once. At least not that I noticed. Can't believe he possibly did travel. And he still has 1500 gold. That is one farmed enigma. This is what you get if you get 2 kills and the first blood at the start of the game before the game even starts. Edict Nova, Beastmaster is in trouble, gonna do a roar to try to get away, but look at that Edict damage! He would have been better off standing next to the creeps, actually. Vacuum there, mechanism being used, Malphiz on the Darkseer who goes down, Lashrak 2 gets something out of that. Beastmaster staying alive though. If Beastmaster would have stayed closer to the creeps here, the Edict would have split up to more people and they might have been able to do something there, but Beastmaster getting so low, making sure that he wasn't able to get back into that fight. And Brax coming there to help out his teammate. Brax being all over the map, playing a good game here. Mechanism, I mean, he used his boots of travel to help out his teammate, and it worked out. Perseverance up on the Lashrak. I mean, support Lashrak going for the Bloodstone. Why not, right? Oh. Yeah, almost. Well, he has it complete. There we go, Bloodstone. I was gonna say. Bloodstone complete. He doesn't have anything else but boots and a Bloodstone though, but you know what? I don't think he really cares. I think he's just having a good time regardless. 2k gold up on the Venomancer as well. He's also playing support. It's just the difference are so massive. Net worth, same thing. Rubik being lowest there and he has boots and he's got 3 branches. Edict there, tier 3 tower, getting pressure. There's no fortification anymore. Power shot will do some damage. And Fate Gold as well, but Mechanism is there to help out again as well. Look at that damage to the tier 3 tower. Just going so fast. Vacuum in, and a song being used. Venomancer ulti as well. We'll just make sure that they don't take any damage from the Venomancer ulti though. Korok being very low on ice, but 40 HP there. Song strike! BAM! There goes the Aegis. Gale hits us still on the Darkseer. Shackle doesn't last though. Malefice does, and Snare as well. Vacuum's still there, but that doesn't matter. Windrunner picking up the kill and Team Austria backing out as they know they're no longer in the advantage here.
My gratitude.
Nice stun strike though, I have to admit that. And they did not get the tier 3 tower. Looks like they still want to though, they still have a black hole. They've got a mechanism again in a second. Get that HP back up, they still have their mana. Axis will fly from the Beastmaster, a bit of a counter push here, but Mechanism will make sure that doesn't matter anymore. Tier 3 tower will drop fortification at 14 HP. There we go.
Dire's middle tower has fallen.
It's gonna be the barracks, it's gonna be the next target, and it doesn't look like Team Austria is really comfortable in going in here. They know that there's no song up just yet, but they also know that the song has such a short cooldown. It's just 50 seconds left. Oh, Omni Slash, 4-star 4, and Lashrak's still alive. Blister, can you still do something? Sunstrike! Oh, gets split over 2 targets. Brax taking a roar though, taking a lot of damage, trying to do something, can't do anything. Lashrak hits on two, but it's too late. Enigma buying back into the game, will be able to TP to a creep close by. Power shot doesn't hit anybody anymore. Team Austria, oh, Lashrak, Axis will take him down. Stuns do hit though, painted gold, getting cold snap, getting 4-star forward, might be enough, it will be enough. Vacuum in 9 seconds. Gale hits on a lot, but it's a surge up on the Juggernaut. There's a kill. Black Hole catches only one, catches the Invoker, but the Invoker will still drop to the Windrunner. Beastmaster on the way out, level 10. He's gonna get ensnared, 4-star forward. Shackle's gonna latch as well, and that is Tanzor dropping to the Enigma, making sure that his buyback was worth it. And Juggernaut on his way back. It's just Juggernaut and Darkseer left up for the Dire team. For Team Austria. And Lashrak already pushed the lane back again and wants to go for more, wants to go for the barracks, because that is what they came here for. 18 minutes in. Over almost 20k gold advantage in favor of Quantic. Experience graph 7,500. 20 to 8 kills. I don't know what Team Austria could do to help this game for them anymore. Telekinesis. Vacuum. Where's the Darkseer? Oh, he doesn't have a wall. Song being used. That's it though. That's it. Barracks will still drop, most likely. One more hit needed. Radiance one more hit needed, 13 HP! They know it's needed! That's the kill! Someone do the damage! Oh, there goes the... No, Naga Siren Creep, nothing gonna do it, not gonna do it. Why is the Siege Creep to be really on the range back? Nope. 14 HP! That's not gonna happen. But yeah. I would say the Darksphere rule, not having one, is quite bad at this point. Purely because if you get an illusion from the Naga Siren, that's gonna be a lot of damage going your way. And it would be worth it, but I don't think apparently he doesn't think so. I can't believe Ranged Melee Barracks is still standing. I mean, Venomizer could just, oh, he's actually placing wards there. I don't think he can force stuff. He will force stuff and die, probably, if he goes there. Yeah, this probably won't be worth it. But Shrek could do it, though. If he force staffs himself forward with the Edict, then he would be able to get it. Iron Lords might be able to do the same. No, there's backdoor protection right now. Never mind. He still wants it, though. And they don't have a black hole anymore. 60 seconds until they have that one anymore. 2800 gold upon the Enigma. Jesus. Sorry. Windrunner. He's got four staff. It's doing its worst side of Vice most likely, since she just has that gold. Four staff on the Venomous, we already saw that also. Bloodstone, we already saw that also. Person that's not there is Korok, who's farming, who has a Radiance complete. We saw the Relic earlier already. And with that Radiance, he's just able to farm so fast if he picks up his illusions as well. In the meantime, though, Brax getting cold staff going down there. Nice Lashrak stun. Nice Shackle. And it will just mark the exit. And again, Sunstrike. Double kill for Killa. Double kill for the Invoker. Picks up the Venomancer, picks up the Enigma. Nice job. Even though it would, would probably be better if the Juggernaut picked those up. What a weird mask he has, I just noticed. Let me check out which masks he has. Rare mask of intimidation. Well, I can see why that is. Typical sword. Ability modifier. But yeah, Juggernaut, it would be okay on Juggernaut, since he would be, as in the kills on Juggernaut would be better, because he's supposed to be the carry. But he did pick up a Vanguard, knowing that he's probably not going to get the damage that he needs to carry this, so he's just going to go for a tanky build and make sure that he's at least not dying, able to do as much as he can before he actually does die. That makes sense. Barracks. I mean, it's good that they regen. Gives Team Austria a bit of hope. If they can defend their barracks long enough, maybe they still have a chance. I mean, they do have to deal with this girl, Naga Siren, 2k gold, who's very low on mana, still low on life as well. So before they actually want to go for a team fight again, I do think she's probably want to be heading home and then back out again. Well, maybe she finds it enough that there might be a mechanism there to help her out and mana boots. We'll find out though. Or maybe she's trying to get lucky with a regen rune, which is not the case. There's no runes on the map just yet. 10 seconds, so she doesn't want to wait for that. Or maybe she does. I'm gonna go for the Ancients. Let's see if she's gonna get lucky. If there's a regen rune here... No, it's invisibility. Okay, not lucky. I was gonna say, that would be the most luck that everybody can have. Too many 200 gold up on the Enigma. Again, he's building towards the BKB because he can't do that. He doesn't want to have a black hole, blink, sorry, he has a black hole. He doesn't want to have a blink dagger purely because he doesn't really need one. I mean, the sleep is enough of a setup for him, but he doesn't need that. And it's only 60 second cooldown at level 3, that is, which is almost the case for Naga Siren, just two more levels. TP's to the tower, he wants to help out killing out Roshan. I don't think there's anything that Team Austria can do against that. Against Roshan, that is. I mean, they don't really have that team fight that they can use to deal with that. Especially now that they're up against an Enigma Black Hole. Rubik has so far not been able to steal any Black Hole. I have to say, I haven't seen him steal that much. Of course, he's only level 8, so he hasn't been level over level 6 that long. Picks up the Yasha. It's gonna go for more illusions. His illusions are cool. With the Mantis Owl, that is. And it looks like that marked the start of yet another push for these barracks. Are they ready for it? No Darkseer roll just yet, still not. And there goes the barracks. Vacuum in the middle of all of that, but then again, like I said, no Darkseer rule. Fade Bolt, Fortification gets forced out. Still no Edict juice though, so with the Edict is there, it's gonna be dropping very fast. There we go. And cold snap on the Magus Siren, who backs out again. She's still not very tanky. Stun from the Shrek, hits up on the Darkseer. Or maybe not, maybe he's just about to sleep. And there will be a black hole. Will he be able to catch all three? No.
Radiance
they
top
back
tower.
Out.
Radiance top
it's too risky. Oh, only slash. It's an 0-4. The vacuum was actually not really good there. Making sure that the Evoker picking out the Lashrak. It is the Enigma that will still drop her. No mana for the black hole. Korok in a very low life, but she has the Aegis. Will be fine. Pain of Gold will drop her as well, though. With only Windrunner left alive on the high ground. Naga Siren back up there. Will try to stay alive. Will try to back up. Power Shot will finish off the Rubick. And it looks like Team Austria on the way out. Tanzor is going to be in a lot of trouble. Will get picked off. Double kill for a Chipmunk. It's going to be Invoker. The Pops' invisibility will be staying alive. Juggernaut will not be staying alive. Black Hole being used without Brax. Buying back. TPing back with the Boots of Travel. And really getting caught out. Brax making sure that that Black Hole would put to good use. And it was saying that when the vacuum hit in that team fight, the Omni Slash was going on. Actually making sure that the Omni Slash hit on way more heroes than just the one that he was started on. He might have had a kill if there was no vacuum. Just saying. Of course, we'll never find out, but I do think that was a slightly wrong call. But then again, no Wall of Replica. I do think that is a wrong call as well. Venom or Windrunner being stunned, forced herself into the low ground. Gale hits on the Rubick. Rubick, who still hasn't. Well, now he steals a spell, gets a Malefist, nice spell to have, but lands in on Illusion. Riptide for everybody. And there goes a Fade Bolt. Rubick on low HP has to back out there again, but the barracks already down. They got what they came for, and now they're gonna wait again. Until they have a black hole once again, until they have the song once again. Bloodstone with only two charges. BKB being built on the track, but I don't know. I can't believe also that this Enigma actually bought back. And still has 2400 gold. How did that happen? This Enigma just so farmed. 119 last hits, and he's not even the most farmed in the game. I mean, that's the Naga Siren net worth being almost at 12k. Yasha, Radiance, 2600 gold. If she wants to go for a meta style, she's almost able to get it. Just 100 more gold and she has it. We have a Darkseer building a pipe. Mechanism on the Beastmaster. They need those items to stay alive through that combo that's going off. If they stay alive in the black hole, if that happens, if the sleep black hole happens, and the Shrek stuns and Edict and Nova, and the Power Shot and the Venomous Ulti, if they stay alive after that, which is of course quite difficult, then they will be able to. They will definitely need that mechanism, and the pipe needs to be up before that. Oh, there goes the song. They want to just catch out the Darkseer. We'll be able to do so though. Here comes the ensnare. Here comes the damage, and here comes the kill. And Enigma picking that one up because he doesn't have enough farm already. He's got 2900 gold, and he does have enough to buy his BKB if he runs it now. Unless he just wants to have it for another buyback. Two minutes, 25 seconds. He's been buying back a lot for this game. And now he has a Wall of Replica. With his level 13, he picked it up. Because there was nothing else to skill. Still, Venomancer able to kill. Oh wow, bottom lane, sorry for that. Invoker picking up the Lashrak kill while Venomancer on the way out and managing to pick up the Juggernaut kill. And landing a Gale still on the Illusions might be able to kill off the Invoker. Was there someone else here? I don't think so. Venomancer versus 2, able to kill off something, or at least, oh, Blister being turned into a Picked Telekinesis. Chipmunk in some trouble, trying to Windrun himself away. Ensnare is working on the Juggernaut right now. Another Ensnare that got stolen up on the Shrike, but he can stand up with his Edict, with his Nova, will still be able to help kill off the Juggernaut. Naga Siren picking up the last hit. Black Hole catches 2, and Beastmaster in there. Deafening Blast will interrupt it. Nice come off from Killa here as he tries to stop what is happening. He's trying to do it properly, but, oh, and that, well, Naga Siren still song, able to back off. Well, Naga Siren was killed, but you still hear the song going off. Quite awkward. Sunstrike! Ooh, close. But Naga Siren still killed off. It's the Windrunner that's getting away with very low HP. Naga Siren tried to song right before she died, but it was not enough. Juggernaut still died as well as the Darkseer, but at least the Beastmaster stayed alive. Beastmaster was caught in the black hole as well. Tier 3 tower still alive, so they still managed to defend it. I still can't believe. Did Venomancer really 2 versus 1 that and kill off the Juggernaut? Really? I don't know. I wish I was there. BKB up on the Enigma won't be able to buy back anytime soon. Or I say that knowing that he is actually farming like a madman. Won't be able to buy back right now. With the only buyback so far being on the Invoker. Invoker, I have to say, who is playing a marvelous game here? He has been on par with all the spells that he is throwing out. Just now, four step forward, Deafening Blast, able to interrupt that Black Hole from going off. Sunstrike, that have been killing a couple of heroes. He is really doing a good job with that Invoker, but it is not enough. He is not able to carry his team, not through the team fight ability coming off from the Dire team, sorry, from the Radiant team, not through the carry potential from the Radiant team either. He is just, it is just not enough. They need to have more people on top of their game like that, and the buyback from Invoker is now actually gone because he picked up a ultimate orb. It's gonna go for a sheep stick probably, as he wants to be able to help have something stop that Naga Siren, even though they did kill her off earlier. They have got the Venomance of Warstone up on the Rubik. Nice hero to have, a nice spell to have, I should say. Nice hero to have also on your team. Naga Siren. Lincoln Sphere. Okay, who cares about a. Whoa, Naga Siren! Deafening Blast, that would be a kill. Darkseid picking it up. Nice smoke up, successful smoke up. I mean, no Lincoln Sphere, no Manta Style for the Naga Siren. Actually, going for the Lincoln Sphere. Already got the recipe. Just these two ultimate orbs to go for both the Manta Style and the Lincoln Sphere. And the recipe, of course, but yeah. Ultimate orbs for the win. Juggernaut picked up Yasha. Now able to, as the game takes longer, now able to take some more DPS items as he is able to stay alive, even though we have seen him dying. But if he's able to stay alive long enough, then he will be able to pump out some damage. We've seen him using his Omni Slash, but it's not really all that powerful just yet. Venomancer, good support. Got mana boots, got 4 stats. Pretty firm support. 1500 gold for him as well. So I'm just putting up back the net worth. You see Venomancer being fairly low on the list of gold, but he's actually the only one that is below some of the Dire Heroes. Cold Snap from the Enigma. And Windrunner is trying to back away with that with an invisibility rune. Blade Fury up, War up on Drax. He won't be able to Black Hole for another 8 seconds. We'll go down to the Rubik Fade Bolt. Lushrak Stone, Edict, Nova, nice Shackle, Deafening Blast going through, but it doesn't matter. It's Juggernaut that's already dead. Beastmaster on the run. Tower still goes down, so that is something. And it is a Beastmaster that will still drop Rubik. What are you gonna do? He has got nothing anymore because he just died. The Shrek picked him up. He did have the Split Earth, but he wasn't fast enough to use it. I mean, one thing you have to remember with that Split Earth, if a Rubik gets it, it will be instant. You don't have to deal with the same delay that Le Shrek has, so I don't know why he didn't cast it instantly. Don't know what he was trying to do. Maybe tried to cast a stun so that he may be able to get a kill, but he wasn't able to do that. And he dies. And a tier 3 tower on the bottom lane is going to get pressured, but just the Invoker left up as well as the Darkseer. Is it going to be enough fortification where we popped off? At least that initial edict damage, not going to be able to do anything just yet. Focus Fire there though, and that is a kill on the tower. Naga Siren picking that one up. It's going to be the Barris, it's going to be the next target. Darkseer going in. There we go. There's a Wolf. There's a Vacuum. There's a Vacuum. As well as a Song, but there's the people, there's the Blister not being affected by the Song. Now he is. BKB up on Braxton. Does he want to throw in the Black Hole? No, he doesn't. He backs off. The Omni Slash goes up. Kills off the Lushrak. Darkseid picking up the last hit. Juggernaut on the way out. Lushrak's Edict still doing a lot of damage there. As Naga Siren on the way out as well. Braxton, he still not still has a Black Hole. If you can get it off. There goes the Venomance. A Black Hole being cast. It catches two. He doesn't have a BKB anymore though. And Black Hole got stolen, but instantly interrupted. Nice job, Malefice there helping out. Shackle latches up on the Rubik as he will drop here from the Naga Siren as the Ensnare hits on the Invoker. They don't want to go on it. I don't think they will. I don't think they want to. Oh, wow. Roar going off on the Windrunner. And she's actually going to stay alive for now. She has a ship to complete. It is the Naga Siren that picks up the Invoker and Snare upon the Beastmaster still as the Power Shot goes through. There is also a Shackle, but that doesn't let Kurok in the middle of all of this. He's still going to go for this and uses his sleep again to go out. In the meantime, I mean, this team fight lasted long enough for two sleeps to be used. I mean, really, in the meantime, Melee Barris goes down. And I just noticed that the ability modifier was actually for the Healing Ward, which looks kind of funny. I didn't see that before. But the Healing Ward was just killed off anyway. We saw it drop. It literally dropped and toppled over. Tower is under attack. And I mean, they got their Melee Barracks. They put up a good fight, I have to say that. Team Austria is not giving up very easily, but they are losing in the long run. Look at that gold difference. It's still, it is not going up that fast anymore as it was in the beginning. Oh, Blister. Go down.
Yep, you're dead.
Yep, he's dead. but it's still going up. Same thing goes for the experience graph. Not as convincing as the gold graph, but still 15k is a lot of experience difference. You see the range barracks being tempted and snare. Vacuum will not do anything anymore. Neither Siren picking up the kill. And I'm not would not be surprised if we see a GG anytime soon, because this damage that is coming out from the Radiant team is just so much. Linker Sphere completed up on Korok.
Dire's bottom barracks.
And we will see them rotate towards the top lane. Tier 3 towers almost dead there already. Maybe they're going through the base. They might just do that mechanism being used. Black hole for another minute, but you know, who cares? Picking up the buildings on the way there. Something got stolen. It's the demonic conversion. Dyer's tower will still drop though, and they can pick that one up. Dyer's there's the edict helping out. There's no fortification. Fate will go through telekinesis, and the song once again hits on everybody around. Will there be another black hole? Nope. There's a midnight pulse though. BKB. Roar up on Brax, but he doesn't care. It's already a double kill for Korok on his Naga Siren. Invoker and Rubik died. So fast. And the GG gets cold. I mean, no surprise, really. Quantic putting up good fights. And Team Austria, they really tried. And we saw them having some good comebacks, or at least attempting at comebacks. But every time again, Quantic punished them for trying. Punished them for trying to come back and made sure that they didn't get anything back. Oh, there's the healing ward. It looks kind of funny. Oh, there it goes again. Falls over. Omni Slash is not doing that much. GG, well played. Going up once more. Beastmaster dropping once again. Black hole because they can. And that is everybody on the Dire team dead. There's a tier 4 tower, so dead. Throne is gonna be dead soon. This was a round 4 match. We might see a round. Oh, actually, I already know. I already know which match is gonna be up next, or at least I think so. We're gonna see Infused versus Garage Gaming, which is actually including Dendy, NS, Horst, and Kebab. And we'll be going into that next. So stay tuned. My name is Shiver. I'm a Ghost of Gamers caster. You can follow me on YouTube, youtube.com/ShiverGaming. And you can follow 4PL, because this is a match for 4PL Cup. Go to facebook.com/4PL.dota2. Like them, give them some love, so that we can see cups like this more often. And we will jump ourselves into the next game. Stay tuned for more Dota 2 action to come.